Hello, just today I bring you to do another exercise. We call it access list. Okay, this access list is very basic rules, very basic security in Cisco router, or you can use this one to prevent access from one PC or some PCs to cannot to access to some PCs or a network. Okay, so in my example, I will implement on GNS3, and I want to prevent from one PC. I don't want to that PC access to one PC using ICMP protocol, but the other two PCs are allowed to access or to ping, okay, to one PC. Okay, I can call it server. Okay, in this example, I just want to show you how it works, how a access list works. Okay, so please wait for GNS3 VM to start, and then we can design our project. Okay, now we can start a new project. I can call this access list. Okay, exercise, let's say. I will use two routers and I will use static routing protocol. One, two, right? And I will use two normal switches. Connecting to router one and one switch connecting to router two. Okay. And I will need one PC here. One PC here. And one PC here. Then I also need another one PC here. Total, I have four PCs. Okay. So let me design diagram. PC one, PC two, PC three. And PC4. PC4, I can say this is a server. Okay, PC1 here. Sorry. PC3 here. Okay, let me link from router one. Sorry. From router one, I will use G2/0 to switch one. Okay. And then I will link from switch number two to G1/0. Then I will link to G0/0 to router two, G0/0. And then from router two, 1/0 to the switch. And then from switch, any port. Connect to PC, any port connect to PC, any port connect to PC. Okay, let me close this one so that I can have more space. This is a server I want to use for allow these PCs to access and not allow to access. So these two PCs is one network. This one PC is another network. Okay, so no, I don't need to use this one. I just give the address IP 192.168.1.2/24. Okay, this is I forgot to give the gateway. 192.168.1.1. Okay. And PC number 2 will be 1.3. Okay. PC number 3 2.2, okay, 2.1 is the gateway, and server so I call this is a server. Server will be 3, let's say 3.3. okay, the gateway is 3.1. okay, 3.1 is here. Let me show the interface label GZ2/0, G1/0, G0/0, okay, and G1/0. And between the two points, point to point links, I will use 4.1/30 for point to point link. So this one will be 4.2. Okay. 4.2, and the interface of G1/0 is not 30. 2.1, okay, 2.1. 2/0, 1.1, okay. So now I have finished assigning the address for all devices. So let's start all devices here. And then I want to connect all consoles. Okay, PC 1, 2, 3, router 1, router 2, and server. Okay, let me assign PC 1 address IP 192.168.1.1/1.2/24. Gateway 192.168.1.1. Okay. I have seen my mistake here, 192. Okay. This is also 192 because I copy and paste 192. I'm using class C address 192. Yeah, 192. Okay. Next for PC 2. IP 192.168.1.3/24 gateway 192.168.1.1. Okay. PC3 2.2, right? 2.2. IP 192.168.2.3, right? /24 gateway 192.168.2.1, and then server. Okay, what is the server address? IP 192.168.3.3/24 gateway 192.168.3.1. Okay, now I have done assigning address to all PCs include server. So let's start configuring routers. Okay, so first I start from router 1. Enable Conti. For the security of routers like SSH or console or enable password, you can following my previous videos. Okay, and in this video I will not include SSH password or enable password or any other security. Okay, I just want to implement only access list on routers. Okay, and this exercise I will use standard IP address. Okay, as you know that standard IP address we are using for prevent accessing from other PCs to access to another PC through a router port or router interface. So this router interface is very close to the destination. Okay, so my destination is server. Okay, so I will implement standard IP in router 2, not in router 1. In router 1, all PCs are the source. Okay, in router 2, all PCs are the destination. Okay, and I can use this port or this port. If I use this port, I will use the inside. If I use this port, I will use outside filtering. Inside filtering, outside filtering. Okay, so first I enter the configuration in router 1. So first I go to interface G2/0, no shut IP address 192.168.1.1. Okay, 255.255.0. Okay, and then INT G1/0, NoSHAD IP address 192.168.2.1 255.255.255.0 and then the G0/0 NoSHAD IP address 192.168.4.2 this one /30 right 252. Okay, so now I need to do a static route. Okay, I need to do a static route. As the server, we have 3, okay, 3.3, so the network will be 3.0, okay, 3.0. So I go back to router 1. I use IP route 192.168.3.0 with the subnet mask of /24 and my next hop will be 192.168.4.1 okay .4.1 so 4.1 is here router 2 interface okay my next hop to reach 192.168.3.0 network okay enter. As I told you just now, I'm not applying access list on router 1. I apply access list on router 2 only because I'm using standard IP access list. Because IP standard we are using for router that are close to the destination. Okay, so I start enable conti. INT G0/0 no shut IP address 192.168.4.1 okay this is also /32 30 right and then INT G1/0 no shut IP address 192.168.3.0 sorry 3.1 okay and then I use static route back to router 1 IP route 192.168.2.0 255.255.255.0 my next hop will be 192.168.4.2 okay one more because at router 1 we have two networks okay 1.0 and 2.0 okay then I start assigning access list on router 2 okay so I will use access list 1 okay I will use access list 1 so I start access.list1 okay and then I will permit 1.2 I will permit PC1 be able to ping to server in one network okay but in one network all PCs will be denied okay all PC will be denied once again in network 192.168.1.0 I allow only PC1 be able to access to server the rest of the 1.0 network cannot access to server it's mean deny but in PC3 there are another network okay is 2.2 so I also permit the 2.2 can access to the server okay can access to the server so my first one I will use permit okay access list 1 permit what is the address that I permit 192.168.1.2 okay .1.2 if I specify the host I'm not using the subnet mask. If I specify only the host, I'm not required to assign or to put the subnet mask. Okay. And then I also want to prevent in access one also, but this time I deny. Okay, this time I deny for all networks. 1.0, I permit only the host with address 1.2. Now I deny all. 192.168.1.0. If I deny all and I mention a network, I need to give a wildcard subnet mask. Okay. I need to give a wildcard subnet mask. 0.0.0.255. Okay. One more. I need to allow or permit the rest of 2.0. Okay. The rest of these networks I permit to access to server. Okay. So the same 2.0, not deny, permit. Okay. It will run and checklist from top to bottom. Remember, if the source coming from 1.network, it will check. Is it 1.2? No, it's not 1.2. If it's not 1.2, it will check on second line. Okay, 1.2 or not? No, it's not 1.2. It's come to second line. Is it not 1.2? Yes, it's not 1.2. It's 1.3. So 1.3 deny. Okay. If the source from the two network, so is it 1.2? No, it is 2.3. It's come to check it on at the second line. Is it 1.0 network? No, it's not. Is it 2 network? So 2 network permit. Okay, 2 network permit. So we can try it now. Not yet. We have to assign to interface. We haven't assigned to the interface yet. Okay. If you want to assign or apply this access list in G0/0 interface, you need to give the in. Okay. In. If this one, if you want to apply to this interface, you need to use the keyword out. Okay. So I go to interface G0/0, and then I say IP access dot group 1 in. Because I'm using this interface, it means when the packet is coming from here, it means in to the router. If into the router, it will check. Okay. If you are in this interface, then you give the command out, it will not check this permission. Okay. It will be not check the access list. If you want to use out, you need to use 1/0. Okay, and then I hit enter now, and then now we can start to test. So I ping from PC1 to server. Server is 3.3, right? Ping 192.168.3.3. Okay, I can ping from 192.168.1.2. I can ping to 3.3. What about PC2 is 1.3? Ping 192.168.3.3. You see the message? prohibit. Okay. It means not accept. Okay. Not accept. What about PC 3? Ping 192.168.3.3. This one also allow because in router 2 we have given permission, okay, for 1.2 but not the rest. I block all but deny all, permit only one. Okay, here I permit all. Remember, if you specify the address or specify the host, no need wildcard mask. If you want to use the whole network, you need wildcard mask. Okay, so I hope this exercise can help you to understand more about access list in Cisco router. So if you have any question, any doubt, please comment on below the video, then I will answer. Yeah, and thank you for watching.